One way to solve this problem is to add a count to the modular exponentiation routine given in class. But I'd like to discuss another way of counting the number of multiplications. First, I want to observe that when a number is represented in binary, it's easy to tell if it's odd or even. All you have to do is look at the last digit. For example, 10 is 1010, and 11 is 1011. And dividing by a 2 is a shift right. For example, 20 to 10 to 5 is a shift and then another shift. In our modular exponentiation routine, if our exponent is even, we divide by 2, and it costs 1 multiplication. And if our exponent is odd, we subtract 1 from it, which will make it even, and then we divide by 2. So if our exponent is odd, it costs 2 multiplications. From this, we can easily see that for every 1 in the exponent, when written in binary, we do 2 multiplications, and for every 0, we only do 1 multiplication. Writing our 4 exponents in binary, where 1023 is, that should hopefully be 10 ones, gives us a cost of 20. 1025 has a cost of 13. 4096 should be 1 followed hopefully by 12 zeros, gives a cost of 14. And 4097 gives a cost of 15. So 1023 is our most expensive operation, and that is our correct answer.